Hello everyone, SP Architects here. Today I will tell you why I don't always want glass facades as an architect. Glass facades. They're sleek, they're shiny, they're modern. And we've seen them everywhere. In office buildings, luxury homes, even schools. Architects love them. Clients ask for them. Developers expect them. But there's a thought. Do we really want to keep designing with glass by default? I'm an architect, and while I've designed plenty of glass facades myself, I've also started asking tougher questions. Not because I'm against glass, but because I believe in better decisions. Why we love glass? Let's start with the obvious. Glass lets light flood the interior. It blurs the line between inside and out. It offers transparency, views, openness, all the things. We're taught to value in architecture. It's also symbolic. A glass building says we are open, modern, innovative. In cities, glass reflects the sky, neighboring buildings, and the pace of life. It feels dynamic, constantly changing with the light. In renderings, it looks clean and futuristic. No wonder clients love it. And as an architect, let's be honest, sometimes we love it because it helps us wrap up a design test. A glass box is easy to rationalize, easier to document, and often easier to get approved. But easy isn't always right. The problem we overlook, context ignorance. Too often, glass is chosen without really considering the environment. Is it a coastal area with harsh sun and wind? Is it a historic town where transparency feels alien? Glass looks universal, but design should never be universal. It should be specific. Climate performance. Glass is a not great insulator. Even high-performance glazing systems struggle to match the thermal performance of a well-insulated solid wall. In cold climates, heat loss is significant. In hot climates, it's a solar oven without the right protection. And guess what? All that cooling and heating, it comes with a cost to your budget and to the planet. Solar glare and overheating. You know what else comes with floor-to-ceiling glazing? Blinding reflections, screen glare, and people fighting over where to sit. Without proper shading or orientation, glass facades can make spaces unusable during the certain times of the day. And guess what the quick fix is? Blinds, curtains, interior shades. So after spending all that money on your transparency, we block it out. Privacy and psychological impact. We say transparent as a positive word, but for the people living or working inside, it's not always plus. Humans instinctively seek shelter, protection, enclosure. That's why people prefer to sit with their back to wall, or why they cover up open windows. Too much visibility can actually cause stress, especially in residential buildings. Acoustic and functional issues. Glass is terrible at blocking sound. If you are next to a busy road or urban plaza, you'll feel like you're in it. And then there's the furniture placement. Ever tried to hang shelves or place storage on a fully glazed wall? Of course not. Maintenance and life skills. That sparkling clean look, it lasts about a day. After that, rain strains, dust, bird droppings, smoke, it all piles up. Cleaning becomes a routine operation, and on high rises, a dangerous and expensive one. And let's not forget, glass breaks, solid walls don't. So, then glass makes sense. To be clear, I'm not anti-glass. In fact, when used thoughtfully, glass can create incredible spaces. Entrance areas, absolutely. North-facing openings in colder climates, great. spaces that demand views, like a hotel, lobby or museum cafe? Definitely. The key is intention. Glass should be used to solve a problem or enhance a quality, not just to look modern. Smarter alternatives and layered thinking. What do I prefer instead of fully glazed facades? I prefer layered design. Here are a few ideas. Hybrid facades. Part solid, part transparent, balancing views and insulation. Screens and lowers. Control sunlight before it even touches the glass. Recessed windows. Deep set glazing that creates shade naturally. Operable shading systems, giving users more control over comfort. Material blends. Brick, wood, terracotta combined with glass to add warmth and texture. These don't just look beautiful, they perform better. They respect the sight. They age more gracefully. So, do I hate the glass facades? Not at all, but I think they're overused, often misunderstood, and sometimes just lazy. Architecture isn't about repeating what looks good on Pinterest. It's about listening to context, respecting the climate, and putting people first. What about you? Have you ever regretted using too much glass in a project? Or maybe had a great experience designing a glass space the right way? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts. And if you enjoy videos to go beyond surface level design, hit like, subscribe and stick around, because we're just getting started. Thank you for watching. Until next video, have a nice day. Bye.